Once in your life, if you are very lucky, you will meet the person who divides it into the time before you met her and the time after.
You were completely drunk, you almost fell on the subway tracks, I pulled you back in the last instant, you called me darling, then you passed out.
I called you darling?
You've shown me eventually what you do.
Okay, what do we win?
A smile.
Why would I want? Why?
I don't care as long as you're here. Go ahead, tell me you leave again. You'll just come back.
Have a level one concussion.
If you take me for everything, do it all over again.
So I think it would be best if you didn't see my daughter again. You're obviously a bad influence on her.
She could really wind up killing me. The reasons to keep seeing her.
I'm in love with her.
I didn't hear from her for a couple of weeks. 3 weeks, actually. 4 days, 9 hours, 20 minutes, 6.5 seconds. Roughly. I had no right to judge her. If I chose to stay with her, knowing the risks, all I could do was give her love and respect and see how the story would end.
Wait, you said you could hug me?
Nobody.
The question is, are we going to be together?
Why do we have to wait a year to find out?
I explained my letter.
That's how we broke up.
You have to go out with other people. You can't just sit around waiting for a year.
Oh.
She wasn't coming. And there was only one thing to do.
Something had to be done. In order for us to have a chance in the future, I had to make a break with the past. I didn't show up yesterday. Well, if he and I were meant to be together, I would have been healed by yesterday.
This is the story of the first and last time I ever fell in love. That the beautiful, complicated, fascinating woman who inhabits my soul. Whether we're together or apart, you will always be the woman of my life. We never see each other again. You're out walking one day and you feel a certain presence beside you. That will be me, loving you, wherever I am.